Hey darlings, welcome back yet to another intriguing, interesting, captivating, and most importantly, hey, educative episode. Today's one is a banger. It's actually a very educative section right here, because tell me, what is growth and development when you don't talk education, where everyone is illiterate or uneducated? How would that country look like? Tell me. But when a country is fortified with highly intellectual and educated personalities that are literate to the core in different facets, in different angles, and in different aspects of education. And for today, ladies and gentlemen, as the ambassador of the motherland, I want to bring to us that yes, soonest, in less than no time, few days from today, yes, it's going to be world-breaking record that the country, the motherland Ghana, will be commissioning amazing schools of different angles, both the STEM, the TVET, when it comes to the government's educational current system of education. About approximately over 20 something schools will be commissioned cut across different states, different regions of the country. Exactly. And yes guys, taking a look at this, I will be giving us a highlight of what we are definitely going to be expecting, reacting to our brother's video. Yes, that will definitely give us a breakdown of what we should look forward to, because as a Nigerian, I know, if you know, you also know that when it comes to education in Nigeria, we are learning and we are trying to improve, we are trying to meet up the goal and the target, and only God knows when that will be. But showing these things on here for our own citizens and different people cut across the world to see and know that this is what is forthcoming, that has already been done and dusted in the motherland, soon to be commissioned, accomplished in the motherland, I will really, really like us to take an in-depth look, exposition based on reaction and analysis, what this is all about, and what the Minister for Education, accompanied with the leaders in the country Ghana, are definitely bringing to our table at the end of the day. Let's take a look at these clips and we will be right back to react more and deliberate more on this. Let's go, guys.
To undergo a transformative shift as the Ministry of Education embarks on the commissioning of over 80 educational projects spread across the country. This monumental initiative marks a significant milestone in the government's unwavering commitment to strengthening educational infrastructure and broadening access to quality learning environments for students. The completion of these projects signifies not just the physical construction of buildings, but the laying of foundations for a future where education paves the path to progress, equity, and innovation. Press briefing held at the ministry's headquarters in Accra, the Minister of Education, Dr. Yao Ose Adetwum, addressed a room filled with journalists, educators, and stakeholders. His voice, charged with a mix of pride and anticipation, captured the gravity of the moment. This is a historic moment for our education sector. The completion of these projects reflects our commitment to providing quality education and ensuring that every child has access to a conducive learning environment, he declared. Behind those words was a story of dedication, planning, and the collective push to uplift the nation's educational standards. The projects span across various regions, painting a picture of inclusivity and strategic focus on areas that have long felt the weight of limited resources. Classrooms, libraries, laboratories, and administrative blocks. Each of these structures is not just a physical addition, but a symbol of hope and potential. For too long, many schools, particularly those in rural and underserved communities, have struggled with infrastructure that hampered both teaching and learning. A teacher trying to explain complex concepts in a crowded, under-resourced classroom, or a student sitting on makeshift desks, straining to catch each word spoken. These were common scenes that defined the challenges faced by the education system. Now the narrative is poised to change. Dr. Adetwum emphasized this shift in his remarks, recognizing that educational disparities rooted in geography or economic status should no longer dictate the quality of learning a child receives. We recognize that a strong educational foundation is essential for the development of our nation, and these projects are a step toward bridging the gap in educational resources, he said, his voice steady and determined. Among the most promising elements of this initiative are the state-of-the-art science and technical laboratories that will soon open their doors to students eager for a hands-on approach to learning. These facilities are set to transform the approach to STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, an area that has become a cornerstone of modern education. Picture a classroom where young minds, once limited to theories and worn-out textbooks, now have the opportunity to experiment, to question, and to innovate. With gleaming lab benches and equipment that meet contemporary standards, these laboratories represent a tangible step toward nurturing a generation of thinkers and problem solvers. Dr. Adetwum was emphatic about the importance of STEM in preparing students not just for local opportunities, but for a global stage. Investing in STEM education is vital for nurturing the next generation of innovators and problem solvers, he noted. Yet the impact of these projects goes beyond brick and mortar. It lies in the echo of voices, the collective ambition of communities, and the realization that change does not happen in isolation. This commitment extends to enhancing teacher training and professional development programs, a crucial component often overlooked when infrastructure is discussed. Dr. Adewum's acknowledgement of this reality underscored the ministry's holistic approach. We are committed to equipping our teachers with the skills and knowledge they need to effectively engage students and facilitate learning. To understand the significance of this move, one must consider the context. The teachers, who play the indispensable role of shaping young minds, are often the unsung heroes of any educational reform. Their ability to harness new tools and methodologies determines the success of any investment made in infrastructure. A state-of-the-art classroom is rendered ineffective if the teacher standing at the front lacks the training or support to use it to its full potential. With these new projects, the ministry aims to harmonize modern facilities with empowered educators, creating a learning ecosystem where potential is not only sparked, but cultivated and expanded. As the date for the grand commissioning approaches, anticipation builds not only in the corridors of the Ministry of Education, but throughout communities far and wide. Schools that once bore the marks of neglect will soon stand renewed, their transformation symbolizing a renewed commitment to the nation's children. Local leaders, parents, and education advocates have expressed hope and gratitude, recognizing that these developments hold the promise of a brighter future for their children. One local education advocate, voicing a sentiment shared by many, said, "Access to quality education is a right for every child, and these new facilities will provide our students with a better chance to succeed." The commissioning event on November 21st promises to be more than a ceremonial unveiling. It is poised to draw key stakeholders from across the education sector, including government officials, development partners, and community members. These attendees, drawn together by a shared commitment to progress, will witness firsthand the fruition of efforts that began as a vision and evolved into a comprehensive plan. It is a moment to reflect on the strides made, to celebrate the collaborative spirit that made it possible, and to look ahead to the work that remains. Behind the scenes, educators and school administrators are preparing for this next chapter. They understand that the new infrastructure comes with new responsibilities and opportunities. Conversations about how best to integrate these resources into daily teaching practices are already underway. The anticipation is palpable in staff rooms where teachers share ideas and strategize about lesson plans that will take advantage of these modern spaces. There is a shared acknowledgement that with enhanced infrastructure comes the chance to elevate the quality of education provided. The ministry's efforts do not stop at building facilities. Recognizing that educational progress must be sustained by a culture that values and supports learning, an awareness campaign is set to follow the commissioning. This campaign will aim to foster community involvement and highlight the importance of education as a shared response.
At this point, guys, I am really impressed. If I tell you that I'm not impressed, I am lying. I am a hater, and you know I'm not one. Yes, I love good things. See, the thing is, it takes someone who loves progress, growth, and development to always look out for things like that, because you are what you like. You attract what you like. And I am keen on it because I love growth and development. And when I see things that are not in my country, Nigeria, I always like to, you know, look at it critically, learn from it, improve, and actually give rooms for replicating them in my own country and showing out so that people who have dreams, ambition, intentions to learn, copy, and replicate will do that. Yes, we all grow by learning from each other and improving positively in our lives as citizens, as countries in West Africa and Africa to the world. Exactly. And looking at what the motherland has put up when it comes to the current and updated version of educational system, educational pattern of learning infrastructure, name it the TVET, the STEM, and technical aspect of learning, the theoretical, in fact, even the conventional education is top-notch. And did I tell us that everything is totally and absolutely free, that will be running effectively well? I mean totally free. This is very far from what we experience in Nigeria. And that's why I really want us to see these things here critically as a Nigerian with clear minds, my non-biased objective and opinion to say, is this not what emulating? Is this not what achieving as a country or countries in West Africa by replicating it in Nigeria? What will happen? After all, if we say or claim that we are the giant, why are we the giant? We should be the giant not by population, but by innovation, invention, growth, and development in all aspects, all areas, not just in one aspect and the rest is a flop. No, I know that there are challenges that we face as countries, yes, as Nigerians, and definitely it is really causing us setbacks. There are areas too that we are actually doing well, truth be told, and there are also areas we need to improve. But looking at what the motherland Ghana is showing us that they are doing in their educational sector, I think and I wish this to be replicated in my country so that it will be a thing of joy, happiness, growth and development for everyone, not just me. Especially if you are a lover of good things, growth and development. This is my opinion, this is my input, this is my two cents, without sentiment, without bias, just saying it just the way it is, nothing but the bitter truth. I know it might not really sit well with so many people, and some of you will say, ah, why talk about it? Yes, it's worth talking about because we should not be the bearer of bad news, negativity and stagnation. We should always be the bearer of good news, positive news, growth and development, no matter whom you are, except you are a hater. And if you're not a hater, kindly at this point tell me what you think in the comment section. What are your thoughts, your opinions, your objectives down there in the comment section? Because if you don't tell me, I will not really know if you truly are in line and in conjunction with what you have just watched. No matter whom you are, like I said, it doesn't matter if you're a Ghanaian, a Nigerian, citizen of any country in West Africa. A win for one is a win for all. This is my opinion and my watchword. I want every country in West Africa to win. I want every country in Africa to win. And Africa leading us to the map of the world in a positive limelight in all ramifications. This is my opinion, my goal and my objective, my ambition right here on this channel and every other channel I find myself, both in real life and in online. Exactly. Thank you very much at this point for patiently watching and listening. I truly appreciate your time, your effort and your patience. I do not and cannot take it for granted. And guys, with this I will say we've come to the end of what we have today. Like I said, leave your thoughts and opinion. If you are yet to like this video and you like it truly, kindly hit on the like button, I beg of you, and definitely share this video so that more people will get to see what we have going on in the country Ghana. And as well, if you are new here, you're just coming across this channel, I truly appreciate you. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for joining. Kindly do not make this your last as you hit on the subscription button. I tell you, it's totally and absolutely free of charge. You can as well go further to join my membership because I'm working on a series for my members only who will be so much fed with a lot of delicacies of good videos and interesting videos. So join the membership. And as well, appreciate this video in any way or form that you so desire. And I will be very, very grateful. I do not and can't take you for granted. And for being a part of this family, of vibing to nature, vibing to life, positive energy, growth and development, you are special. God will continually bless and keep you till the end of time. And definitely reap the fruit and the benefit of your labor. Nothing at the long run will cut you off. Nothing at the long run will deprive you of your peace of mind, your happiness, and your sanity. Exactly. Continue keeping it real as you vibe to everything while vibing positively. Till I catch you in my next one. But for now, this is me, your host, Vibe with Chivik, signing out. Ciao, ciao.